meeting of the Ramsey County Commission order, please stand for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
We will open the minutes of the last meeting. Move to approve.
Sorry, wait a second.
I'm giving it to you.
Okay, I'll second.
Give the second, yeah. Any additions or corrections to the minutes? Seeing none, all in favor, vote by saying aye.
Aye.
Pull the same sign, motion carries. Approval of bills.
I need to add one. Lake Region District Health submitted a voucher for their first quarter mill levy for $53,549.
Okay. Just add that to the bills. Anything other than that out of the ordinary?
Nope.
$53,549?
Yep.
And then all right, Andy?
Yep. It's just the stragglers that came in after nobody's really spent anything after we paid them last time, so.
Move to approve the bills.
Okay.
Second.
We have a motion and a second to approve the bills. Further questions? Seeing none, roll call please.
Brown?
Aye.
Olson?
Aye.
Wakefield?
Aye.
Frith?
Aye.
Lightfoot?
Aye. Motion carries. Approval of the financial reports.
It's a new year.
Nothing too exciting so far.
No, the liability report that you got is before Lisa does, before she does. How it works is we have to close books first and then she does the transfer of December. So we're gonna put down another liability report after to let you know where we actually sit to start out the year. This is just end of the year.
I didn't look like there was anything too out of the ordinary, the one around under budget other than maybe line items or anything.
Yeah, and those few were money that we didn't get back from the state yet.
Okay. Any further questions on the financials?
Move to approve.
Okay, we have a motion to approve.
Second.
We have the seconds. All those in favor for approving the financials, vote by saying aye.
Aye.
Pull the same sign, motion carries. Treasurer's checks. We have a motion to approve.
Second.
We have the seconds. Any questions on the treasurer's checks?
Nothing, I don't know.
Yeah, I was just gonna say, who's this Core Logic refund? Just out of curiosity, say.
That's like a big escrow.
Oh, okay, so we're refunding the fact that they overpaid in escrow to the mortgages, okay.
When they get a packet of like hundreds.
Yeah, they have a bunch.
Thousands of dollars, yeah.
Yeah, they overpaid in a few situations that happen. Okay. Any further questions? We have a motion and a second, correct?
Yep.
Okay. All in favor, vote by saying aye.
Aye.
Oh, excuse me, yes, roll call, you're right.
Wakefield?
Aye.
Frith?
Aye.
Olson?
Aye.
Brown?
Aye.
Lightfoot?
Aye. Motion carries. Thank you for reminding me. Approval of the agenda. We have a motion approved, second.
Second.
We have a second. All in favor, vote by saying aye.
Aye.
Pose same sign. Motion carries and the agenda is set. Okay. Approval of year-end budget amendments.
One is expenditures, like the colored one is the expenditures, and then the other one is the revenue. And it's, you know, for the general fund, we came in just over 200,000 under budget.
Okay, the general fund did, okay. You did very well.
Everybody did.
You need to take somebody at the top to crack the whip.
I just watch, so it's not.
You watch, oh, sorry.
Yeah.
You won't be a bit whip.
Nope, nope. Yeah. And everything else, we just, like the flood accounts, we just transferred the money.
For the end of the meeting?
Yep.
Yeah, because we had a lot of cuts.
Yep.
Almost done, like it's all.
Yep.
Money's there, so.
Money was there, we just needed to, yeah.
Need a motion to approve these, right?
Yes.
We have a motion to approve the year-end budget amendments, we have a second.
Second.
We have a second, any further discussion or questions on the budget amendments?
Okay.
No further questions, all in favor, the motion vote by saying aye.
Aye.
Pose same sign. Motion carries. Okay.
I guess there's, who do you want now, social service, maybe I have one. Who knows, will everybody notice that second page and that money that was transferred on social service in general?
Yeah, we'll be approving that down the line. Yep, separately on the new business, but, yeah, so we can discuss it then. Yeah. Okay, we'll go over here. Okay, first of the year business, we have the different motions that we set every year, just for the basis of doing business, I guess. Would you like me to ask, please read them separately here? The first motion will be to state that the entire board will meet on all matters pertaining to the various offices and undertakings unless authority is granted to an individual member of the commission to act for the board, and that the county auditor is authorized to pay all regular bills such as monthly salaries, lights, heat, water, telephone, bills with discounts, and human service bills when received.
So moved.
We have a motion and a second. Further discussion. Seeing none, all in favor of the motion, vote by saying aye.
Aye.
Pose same sign. Motion carries. The second, first in a motion that we do is that no county official or employee shall order equipment, supplies, or services amounting to $1,000 or more without permission from the county commission, except for emergency supplies that the department supervisor would deem necessary to authorize.
So
we have a motion to approve that. We have a second. Further discussion. Seeing none, all in favor of the motion, vote by saying aye.
Aye.
Pose same sign. Motion carries. The third, first of the motion, would be that Ramsey National Bank and Trust, Bremer Bank, and Western State Bank, all of Devils Lake, North Dakota, will be designated depositories for Ramsey County.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Further discussion. Seeing none, all in favor, vote by saying aye.
Aye.
Pose same sign. Motion carries. Let's see. Next, that the Ramsey County Treasurer be authorized to invest county funds as soon as available and to cash in investments when necessary.
So moved.
We have a motion and a second to allow that. Discussion. Seeing none, all in favor, vote by saying aye.
Aye.
Pose same sign. Motion carries. Next, a motion to set the amount of $5,000 for the county's fixed assets.
So.
You have a motion?
Second.
And a second. Out of curiosity, didn't we change that a few years ago, correct? The auditors kind of tell us what they wanted to answer.
Yep, we had to change it to be compliant with the GASB.
Okay, that's right. Okay, further discussion? Seeing none, all in favor of the motion, vote by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, same sign. Motion carries.
And then the last.
And then that's the one you want to do at the second meeting, because we have to have the dollars and then we have to allow the treasurer time to.
See, it hasn't gotten.
Yeah, get it lined up. So we'll do that last motion at the second meeting then. Okay, very good. All right. We can actually talk to some people. Beth?
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
I just wanted to update you guys on the Hampden House situation. I did speak with the rural fire department and they do like doing training exercises. However, the location of that house is just out of, it's hard for them to protect Hampden properly and Devil's Lake area with the home equipment they have and to be that far up like that, they thought. So that wasn't, however, there is a person in Hampden that would purchase it for back taxes if they could own the land after it was torn down. So that is something that if you wanted to go forward with, I could, I guess, look at getting estimates of tearing it down, or I'm not sure how you typically handle that if you have to advertise it.
They want us to tear it down.
Right, that they would, that's what we discussed in last meeting, maybe.
I thought we were trying to step around, right?
Right, so that they would own the property, but we'd pay the cost of the demolition.
Kevin, what do you think of that idea?
Well, I think it's a great idea.
Will we take care of the cost of demolition?
That's cool, I don't know what fund it would come out of, but yeah, it seems fair. I mean, it's quite a burden to the homeowner that would have an empty lot in the end.
I can check with Carrie.
Yeah, I was gonna say, have we checked with Carrie about, make sure that's a compliance thing, make sure we're okay to go that way.
Yeah, I can help Beth with whatever she needs to, as far as contractors or whatever.
But we'll have to check for asbestos.
Yeah, not if it's privately owned. If this one, if this individual that wants to purchase it, purchases it first, then we take bids to tear it down, then we get out away from all the. Yeah, because, I mean, we end up, we've agreed to pay the bill. I mean, that was our discussion. But once it said the property's in his name, then we don't have to worry about the asbestos.
Even though we're paying for the demolition.
That's where we need to talk to the state.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, we need to pay you to make sure that we're doing everything.
According to Alan sounded, we don't.
I mean, okay.
But it would be good to check.
Alan.
Oh, in the health department.
Yeah, I think we better check with the state's attorney on that one, yeah. I did, that would be used county fund to clean up private property, I don't know. That don't make sense to me.
I remember doing it in South Dakota, but
You did?
We're in another state up here, so yeah, it better be checked out.
Yeah.
Oh, that worked fine, I guess. Make sure Carrie's on board.
I mean, I guess the other option would be is if, once we figure out if that's available to us or not, is to do basically the same thing we did in town here. We'll tear it down and we'll stick it as a special and see if anyone will buy it for that price, and if not, we can back it down, so we're probably gonna have to do with this one.
What did you say about the rural fire department?
Yeah, they said they wouldn't be able to bear it down.
From here?
Yeah.
They wouldn't go up there.
Right. They didn't feel comfortable being able to protect both places at the same time.
If they had their equipment up there, then they'd have, if they had an incident down here, they'd spread to them.
Who did you talk to?
Shane Whitecall, or Sean Whitecall, maybe his name is actually, I haven't written down, but he's the chief of the rural fire department.
So you work with Kevin and figure out then Carrie and see if it's.
Should probably tear old Carrie first.
Perfect.
Okay.
Thank you. Anything else?
Yeah, one other thing, I just wanted to let you know that Christie is in a class 2 assessor. She passed all of her courses for that.
Great, congratulations.
New year for her. But other than that, that is it.
Great.
All right, thank you.
Great, thank you.
Stacy, good morning.
Good morning, happy new year, and December was considered probably a little slower than the past 4 or 5 months or more. 81 people came through the door, and but that's okay. It was enough to handle right there. We did attend a meeting, or I attended a meeting up in Grafton. We assumed it was going to be with Senator Heitkamp's people, but it ended up being more than that. It was all of the top officials from the Fargo VA were there. There was approximately 50 or so veterans from the Grafton area, and Matthew Lipon was there. So we got to dig on the VA for a while, and we did the most major issue that we had was the absence of their lack of ability to pay travel pay in a timely manner. And they ultimately ended up admitting they have a problem with travel and don't have an answer that's going to correct it in the near future. So the veterans have to get used to the idea of not getting their travel pay for probably a month or more, or we used to get it in 7 days. So that was the biggest issue we had at that meeting. We did bring up other things to the hierarchy there of the VA. There was a gentleman from Sioux Falls who represents the head of Fargo and Sioux Falls. And I mentioned to him the in the news recently in the last month and a half is the what they call inept doctors. And I mentioned that last meeting. And this gentleman from Sioux Falls, he said there is, he took me aside and started whispering because he didn't want this to get out to the rest of the crowd.
You better start whispering to us.
Yeah, but there is a website that is listing the doctors they are trying to get rid of. But a lot of these doctors are also suing the government for them being gotten rid of. So it's a fight. So some interesting stuff goes on with the VA.
Some of this is going on in Fargo?
Well, you know, we turned in one doctor here from, we had three veterans in Devil's Lake that were mistreated by one doctor. We turned him in and there was an ongoing investigation into him. So happens that I'm one of his patients starting next week, so I'll see how that goes. But that's about all I got. Nothing too exciting.
Okay, any further questions for Steve?
Thank you.
Thanks, Stacy. Kevin.
All right. Okay, I got the quotes for, to purchase the NAPI service utility box, and Tommy left. I had two quotes, one from Marketplace for $10,803 and one from Birch Truck Equipment for $11,621.50. I didn't know, but Marketplace is a NAPITE dealer, so they actually just shipped a vehicle from the factory to the NAPITE dealer. So it saves a step there.
Marketplace can put it on and everything then?
Yeah, they actually send it to the NAPITE factory, or and then they put it on, and then it gets shipped back here. There's actually no miles driven or anything. It's just, so yeah.
Where's the NAPITE?
Yeah, Illinois or somewhere in that area.
Interesting.
Do you need a motion to accept a little bit?
Yeah.
So moved.
Second. We have a motion and a second to accept a little bit for the service utility box and Tommy Lift from Marketplace Motors. Any further discussion? Roll call, please.
Olson.
Aye.
Brown.
Aye.
Frith.
Aye.
Wakefield.
Aye.
Lightfoot.
Aye. Motion carries.
And then those features there, I'd also like to add when we order the pickup. Running boards and some toggle switches that would run the beacon and lights inside the service box. heavier leaf springs in the back for that heavier box, and then daytime running lights.
Move to approve.
Second.
We have a motion and a second to approve the four upgrades to the pickup. Further discussion? Seeing none, roll call please.
Frith?
Aye.
Wakefield?
Aye.
Olson?
Aye.
Brown?
Aye.
Lightfoot?
Aye. Motion carries.
And then if you remember, like, we were having issues with the buyout of the Karen Konzak home, and FEMA finally notified us last week that that is being funded now, so. That was a battle. That was about $129,000 that they were trying to hold, but the letter I got said that the house was moved to a high enough location. I'm kind of paraphrasing here, but so that helped us as far as getting funding, and they overlooked some things that we did wrong. That's what the letter said. But bottom line, we got it funded now, so just adds up more than anything. And then the bottom line of my agenda or my list, I have a couple things we added. We got the bill from the DOT for our share of the work that was done on the Rorido crossing. And that amounted to $12,949.50, which was 10% of the project. So I'd like the motion to pay that bill.
Move to approve.
Second.
Okay, we have a motion and a second to pay our share of the Rorido crossing bill from the NDOT. Roll call please.
Olson?
Aye.
Wakefield?
Aye.
Frith?
Aye.
Brown?
Aye.
Lightfoot?
Aye. Motion carries.
And along with that, they sent us a letter asking us where we're getting that money from. In other words, we're not using another federal source to pay our match money, so we have to explain where we're getting that match money from, and that requires a signature from the chairman. So.
Okay, we need a motion to be decided, as I say, we're not totally looking.
Yeah.
Okay.
So moved.
You have a motion?
Second.
And a second. All in favor, vote by saying aye.
Aye.
Both same side. Motion carries. Okay.
And then just to update you on the donation of the sick time for the county employee that we talked about at the last meeting. There was quite a few people that were actually losing sick time, because at the end of the year, some were losing vacation. And just wanted you guys to be aware that we were using that time that was actually being lost, if that makes sense. Anything you want to add to that, Candy? It was just more informative than anything.
Needs a lot of hours.
Yeah.
How's it doing?
Not good. Hey.
We're okay as far as the last paycheck he got, right?
Yeah.
Is that what we figured out?
Yeah, we're plenty ahead. I mean.
Yeah, so now going forward, he's, what is it, like 30 hour? I think that's already gone. He won't have, anything to receive a full paycheck.
With the federal FMLA, whatever that stands for, there's 12 weeks there that legally we're supposed to keep his job open for him. Part of the stipulation, though, is we don't have to pay for his time unless he can find sick time or vacation time. Does that make sense? I mean, we don't have to pay him unless he's got time available. So that's what this donated time will come in on that. But once the 12 weeks is over, then.
Is he in need of additional hours?
Yes, he is. He is out now.
And do we know if we have anybody that has?
We're working.
Okay.
We're waiting for everyone to turn in what was used for the month of December.
Sure.
To see where we sit with total hours. I think we'll have enough for another paycheck.
Yep, for sure.
For sure.
But then if other people decide they don't hate, that'll happen in the future.
We're kind of taking it one paycheck at a time.
Yeah. And if anybody wants details on how he's doing, why, I can certainly discuss it with you, but as long as the camera's around, I'd rather not do it here.
Okay.
And then he did tell me that he's gonna quit, so I need to advertise for that position. That usually is a motion, I don't know.
Move to approve.
Sorry. We have a motion and a second to allow Kevin to advertise for his open position as department. Further discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, vote by saying aye.
Aye.
Both same sign. Motion carries. Why, Kevin?
Kevin, on that Konzac house, was that already paid for and FEMA's reimbursing the county? Is that how that works, or?
Okay, it was paid for to her.
Okay.
When she was around.
Prior to her passing away.
Yes. And FEMA did reimburse us.
Oh.
So we weren't behind, so to speak.
Okay.
But had this not been funded, then we would have had to dig it out of our pockets.
We would have had to pay back, sure.
But now, since it is, we're kind of even at zero, if that makes sense.
Yep.
Yeah, that was the property they funded us, and then they came in and said, oh, we can't fund you.
Yeah.
And they wanted the money back.
Yeah.
So we got it squared away, that's most important.
Thank you.
Thanks, Kevin. Okay. Moving forward, unfinished business, nothing under there. New business, approval of special beverage permits.
Who's for the snowmobile run?
Yes, for the snowmobile run out of the Peterson Arena.
Second.
We have a motion and a second to approve the special beverage permits for the snowmobile run. All in favor, vote by saying aye.
Aye.
Both same sign. Motion carries. Approval of a mileage rate change effective January 1, 2018 from 53.5 cents to 54.5 cents.
Move to approve.
Second.
We have a motion and a second to approve, and all that's doing is trailing the federal rate, correct?
Yep. Terry Joyner.
Yep. We usually do this instead of yourself. Okay, we have a motion and a second to approve that change. Further discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, vote by saying aye.
Aye.
Both same sign. Motion carries. Okay. And then approval of a transfer of social service funds because of 2206. Would you like to kind of get your heads up? Okay. Basically, we figured out Candy's been working with Christy and Rhonda about it. The social service board, and granted, we can do what we want here, but the inclination was basically because of Senate Bill 2205, we could only carry over a maximum of $500,000 in carryover because our budget's over $2 million. But the language in 2206, I don't know if you've ever really gotten a complete, thorough answer. If essentially, if you have any money left over when the cycle is done, then that will roll back to the state. So we thought the best way to do it was just to take the money from the social services fund, roll it, put it in the general, and then we can just kind of pay out year for year as we're going. Then the money will just be sitting there. That way we won't run into the problem of accidentally having too much money in the fund and then, you know, getting stuck basically. I'm gonna cut a check.
2018 is the year we're gonna watch now, future funding. So we didn't want to go in there with the voted carryover and show that. We wanted to show the true, you know, expenditures and budget that way, so.
Yeah, and there's no disadvantage to having less carryover than the 500,000. There's, they don't.
We're not hiding anything.
No, they know what we're doing. They know what we're doing.
It's just so, and what we did. But it's just good to have a transfer into the general.
Yeah, and in all honesty, some counties, I think, were already basically doing this. They were just running everything out and then just billing it out, basically, so.
Yeah. And one thing I like to add, that Christy Chickas up there does an excellent job of the budget up there and making sure we're getting the money for Medicaid and all them programs that we're supposed to. There's grant monies in there also that we received over the last, what, 4 years?
Something like that.
Parts of it, you know, that wasn't used, so. And that was around $500,000 a year that we had been received from the state, so. So some of that's in there. A lot of it goes to Christy. She does a very good job up there monitoring books and making sure we're getting the money that's supposed to come to the town through federal programs and state programs. I commended her during the social service meeting, but I've never commended her, I guess, during county commission. She needs to be patted on the back, I guess. She does a good job.
She does. That they've done a pretty decent job up there of, you know, like you said, finding additional places you can bill for services that we're already providing, so we're getting the benefit there, and they've done a good job holding the line to where our budget's been very good in terms of how they're holding the line on the budget that we're under this year, but it was just,
yeah.
Just no ammo.
Yeah.
That's how you end up with a carryover.
Yeah.
Because you're consistently running under budget, so.
And part of our discussion too was, it wasn't it wasn't exactly explained, but you know, the carryover at the end of this year, how we interpret it may affect
yes
payment
future funding
what we get in 19.
Yeah. Yeah.
So they'd rather have it at zero. Or
well, and that essentially, yeah, I probably did a poor job of explaining it, but one of the concerns was, so if we fund this year's budget and then we leave the $500,000 in the account and then we run under budget this year again, say by $100,000 or something, then they're going to count that $100,000 against us because we did a good job of running the budget, essentially. And we don't want that to occur. So, you know, it's almost better to just start with a zero to a clean slate. This is what the costs are, the mistake.
The state really hasn't told us the rules of how they're under budget in 19. I mean, they haven't really said anything, and so we just want to, we know they're going to watch 18, and that's what's going to determine the funding from here forward.
We haven't really had any guidance now.
Right. They change people down there, and I don't know. We'll see anymore, I guess.
So basically what it comes down to is that sheet that was handed out, that total transfer figure is on the sheet. 834-350-129 would be the transfer back over then. So.
And it's going to be put into a line item in the general fund with their name on it, so we know. You can keep track.
It's no different than when we were supposedly making property taxes simpler, so they got rid of those certain mill levies, and then we.
Yeah.
And just kept the budgets the same.
Yep.
Move to approve.
We have a motion to approve the transfer.
Second.
We have a second. Further discussion.
Just one thing that, you know, they set 18 budget following 15. That's the one we're using. So 2015. So we're, yeah, you know, quite a ways behind as far as cost of living and everything else.
Yeah, that's where the budget funds are, the $356,000.
Yeah, they put some money in it, and it's coming here now.
Yeah. Yeah, and we'll do roll call on it. So, roll call, please.
Brown?
Aye.
Frith?
Aye.
Olson?
Aye.
Wakefield?
Aye.
Lightfon?
Aye. Motion carries. Visitors and delegations. No one's here.
I think one other piece of new business, and I probably should have put it on the, added it to the agenda, is Steve called me yesterday, blew an engine in his squad car.
Oh,
On Friday, and it's going to run about $7,000 to replace. And I said, you know, we've got to get it done. The two that he ordered are going to be, you know, 3 months out before they're here. So we would leave them short of a vehicle. Did he say it had 88,000 miles on it, was all? So, and he said that's the car that they planned on keeping for transfers and things like that. So instead of going ahead and trying to diagnose the problem and individually repairing the, he thought it'd be better and cheaper to go ahead and get a brand new engine put in there. And Marketplace said they could have it done by the end of the week. So he was going to get another price quote, but the person hadn't gotten back to him yet. So the other thing was to check on, I told him to check on time, you know, if he needs it, you know. And the other guy's cheaper, but it's going to be 2 months out.
Yeah.
And, you know, it doesn't become cheap enough. But
yeah,
I told him I'd bring it up and let you guys know about it. So.
Yeah, and I think that kind of falls under the emergency clause, essentially,
right,
where he makes
yeah.
the decision and if he thinks we need to put an engine,
yeah.
we get an engine in it. That's
warranty,
but it's good to know.
I don't think so. He didn't mention a warranty on it, so I'd imagine what is
yeah, probably 50,000 or something like that.
I think the state vehicles are only a year.
Only a year.
Well, how old is this?
That I'm not sure of.
88,000 is more than a year.
It's probably, yeah. I think he said they're averaging about 30,000 a vehicle or something
yeah.
a year, so probably 3 years old.
And it's a Ford.
Yep.
Okay. Okay. Thank you for the information.
Yeah.
It's not good, but it is what it is.
That's right.
Okay. We didn't have visitors or delegations. Report on portfolios. We'll start with Lucas. This you looked at the first one.
All right. The main thing that I wanted to bring up is the new library director has started his position as of yesterday. I stopped in to see if he was settling in all right, and seemed to be enjoying it. He cleaned out that back office that Jim Chapman had for years and years. He was commentating that some of this stuff couldn't even figure out what it was for or where it came from because it had been there for years.
And what's this person's name?
His name is Jared Tolman.
Jared?
Yep. Nice guy. We hired him back in, I think, November,
okay.
early November. And then to give him enough time to move him, and he's got a family, and to give him enough time to make the transition, we had Robin over there act as the acting director, and she deserves to be commended because she did a very good job in the absence of a formal director. But it's very exciting. He's a very nice guy, and I would encourage all of you to drop by the library and introduce yourselves to him and welcome him to the community. We want to make sure that we get somebody who will stay this time. And then the other thing is the Home Rule Charter Committee meets today at 2 o'clock, and you're all welcome to attend, especially those of you who are on the board. You're very welcome to attend. But we'll look forward to that. I'm excited that we're making progress on that. I think that probably not this month, but next month, we will basically begin, should the board, I'm going to call for a vote today at the Charter Committee meeting to decide whether or not the committee feels it's appropriate to draft a Home Rule Charter for Ramsey County, given, you know, everything that we've learned and looked at. And I think that the answer will be yes. We had a really great conversation with, who was the gentleman from Burleigh County?
Kevin Glad.
Yeah, the auditor of Burleigh County. And he said that he really liked Home Rule and he said he was a little bit jealous that Burleigh didn't adopt a more broad, far-reaching home rule charter like Morton did. Am I remembering this correctly?
Yes.
And so he was very positive about the additional options that a home rule charter can give a county, and he was very willing to continue to help us as we move forward. So I'm going to call for that vote today at that meeting, provided that the committee does accept that we should draft a charter. I think you begin to see that in the next month or two. So very exciting. I'm excited that we're making progress. Be happy to report it again soon. But that's all that I have.
Okay. Yeah.
Well, I guess we discussed social service, so I don't think there's too much more to talk about there, and then. law enforcement center, state inspector hasn't been there yet. He's gonna come on and on. But the last visit we had was in November. And everything went pretty well. Some things they had to work on some more, but they got medical areas pretty well taken care of. They worked at the showers and some of them, not all of them, but some of them. When they've had empty cells or empty areas, they've been able to work on that. And the inmates have been doing a lot of work, so it's going pretty well. State has to give us approval for federal prisoners, and that hasn't happened. We anticipate that after the next visit from our inspector, but we feel he'll probably be here, not this week, next week or so. Comment I had, I read in the Herald, Grandmore's Herald, about the Grand Forks County Jail. 81% of their budget through federal funds come from federal prisoners. Their income comes from them, so that's pretty much a huge benefit to our jail, and that makes things happen for them, so. And a lot of them come off the border crossing, when eagles trying to go across there, so. Just thought I'd throw that in. Other than that, I guess senior centers going fine, so. That's all I have.
Okay, thank you. Jeff?
Well, Bill's on his way to Carrington this morning, so he said, just remind everybody about the extension roundup next week, Tuesday and Wednesday. Tuesday kicks off, I think we have breakfast both days, lunch. Full slate of informational topics. He reminded everybody about parking. I wanted me to stress that, parking will be at a premium those 2 days. And that we did agree previously to allow the doors to be open, so. So let's bring that up. I already talked about the sheriff. State's attorney, I haven't talked to Carrie in a while, but I know she's busy with various jury trials and things like that, so it seems like people can't stay out of trouble. And Paula, we haven't had a
No, we did have a meeting in December.
Right.
So, but I wanna thank the board here for a great 2017 and working with us. It's always great to work with you. Look forward to another year in 2018. As far as the chamber, we're kind of just doing kind of community work right now, working on our downtown initiatives still, and working on the Main Street with the committee on the Main Street and the North Dakota DOT grant. Susie and I sit on that committee. We sit on the Home Rule Committee. So we're doing kind of our community service work for a couple of months till something else pops up, which I think is probably the next big thing outside of your Shiver Fest is Devil Drum, which takes a long time to work on as well, so.
I mean, I know there was some concern that the, was it a gentleman who kind of managed it that was no longer going to manage it? Did we?
Stan?
Yeah.
Oh, right. No, Stan's gonna continue. He won't be giving up his baby, I don't think, anytime soon.
Okay. That may have been a rumor that I heard.
I think that rumor did start. He's gonna go 25 and then think about retiring, but no, he's gonna continue with the help of other entities, but
okay. Well, I mean, it's such an excellent, activity for the community that it'd be a shame if we lost it.
Oh, for sure. No, we won't let that go. We'll keep that going. So, and we do have a Coffee and Collaborate coming up January 9th as well, same day as our roundup, but it's in the morning at 9 o'clock, so if you can make it out there, that is on the event calendar, and it's at Dunn Brothers at 9, and so Susie's going to be teaching us all how to use the event calendar a little bit more, so one of those is coming up, and just continue to we'll push out the chamber in any way we can. That's what we're doing now.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks for noticing us sitting here. Anything you want to say, Susan?
No, you pretty much covered it.
Okay.
That's all I got.
All right.
Well, I guess planning and zoning, we'll have the public hearing the 16th following our commission meeting downstairs in the basement.
7 p.m.?
7 p.m. We'll get notices to Candy, so get those published. Joel is working on the wording for those, and then we'll get the documents to Steve to put up on the county's website, the draft documents, for people, the public can review them and take a look and make comments, and hopefully we can get that done and taken care of, and then without any major changes, we could have possible approval at our first meeting in February. So.
Okay. Very good.
We'll see. But thank you.
Thank you. Well, that's fine.
I'm okay with that. Really don't have much on anything. You know, I had touched on the law enforcement center. I know they're we can start tackling some plumbing issues. I think they're going down the right path now. Other than that, Lucas took my spot on the Heritage Center board, so I have nothing there. And the fair board did not have a meeting.
That was simple.
And it was very quiet in my room.
Not a bad thing.
No, it's not.
Okay. Social services, we've obviously talked about. County Housing Authority, we had a meeting last month. Nothing too crazy happening. We were doing pretty well on occupancy rates. We're pushing to try to keep things full, and so we've been doing a good job there now. Forward Devil's Lake. I'm trying to remember what's happened between last meeting and this meeting. we obviously had our Paul Lucy come in and give his overview of the initial draft, and I think we talked about that at the last meeting. He'll be coming in, I believe, in mid to late January. I can't remember the date. I think it's like the 18th or something like that. With his final recommendations and reviews of operations to kind of give us an idea, framework moving forward. And by no means is that going to be the end of the discussion on how we do things going forward. It's just going to be a framework to start the discussion that we can have about how do we envision the organization moving forwards from everybody sitting at the table. So it'll be it's going to be a long process. I think at times it might be a little bit tedious, but it's something that needs to happen so we can get our ducks rolling. I haven't talked with anybody about if we have any more individuals that have applied to be executive director. Last night we had four that had applied. The closing date is the 31st of January, so that's coming up quickly. Rachel's last day was the 20th of December, so we are without an executive director currently. Terry has kind of taken on the administrative duties to a point, and then we also approved at our last exec meeting hiring some temporary help, like administrative assistant, executive assistant type thing through, I can't remember the business's name, the Express Services that works here. That worked really, really well so far. I think he just started the other day. So we're going to try that. We have, obviously we'll have some budget dollars to work with, so we figured we needed somebody there to kind of keep the ball rolling at least short term, and we'll kind of go from there. So I haven't talked with Bernard on it, but it sounded like everything was going well so far. I think other than that, there's a, I can't remember what it's called, the justice recovery thing. Meeting, they're having one meeting at 9 o'clock on Thursday, I believe. I can't remember, they're focusing on peer counseling or something like that, but hoping to make it to that. I haven't had a very good chance of making it. It seems like they're good at scheduling meetings when I already have other meetings. So
the last law enforcement, not to interrupt you, but the last law enforcement center, Rob brought that up, and he said they were looking at a director, and now all the states throw Stetson County with our Jamestown area with this area.
Yeah, you probably honestly have more information than I have, because I haven't been there for a while.
He said that
the state had some additional, has some dollars in there to hire like, yeah, a regional director that's gonna kind of hopefully coordinate services, I think is what the plan is, and try to, you know, try to get the most out of what we're doing.
We had quite a fear that they would probably hire somebody more from Jamestown that would service that.
Well, if we're in that area, yeah, that's quite possible.
So, I don't know, they wonder where they're gonna hire, I guess.
Yeah, then they discussed that at our, at the first couple of meetings I was able to make it to, and it was, the money was out there, I think, previously, but they just, excuse me, had never got to the point of hiring somebody, so. But they're moving forward, I think, so that's a positive thing. It was a large group, a couple times I was able to make it, a lot of passion in the room, so that's a good thing. So, anything else to add?
Move to adjourn.
Good, motion to adjourn.
Second.
We are adjourned.